My name is Seth Ressler. I'm the digital dot connector for Jacobs Media Strategies. And in this short video, we'll talk about text messaging strategy. Text messaging can be tricky for broadcasters. We've seen some big broadcasting companies forced to pay hefty fines for running afoul of text messaging spam laws. That's because the spam laws governing text messaging can be strict. There are trolls out there that know this. Sometimes, they sign up for a station's text message list and wait for the station to send a spammy text. Then they threaten a lawsuit. To protect yourself, I highly recommend that stations always check with their legal teams before implementing any text messaging strategy. One way to avoid legal issues may be to use text messages as a way for people to opt into your station's email list. Here's how it works. Find a text messaging service that integrates with your email service provider. Sign up, and this service will allow you to select a keyword. For example, you might select WKRP as your keyword. When people text your keyword to a number, they will opt into your text message list. So for example, if a person texts WKRP to the number 55555, they'll join the list. You can set up an automatic reply to anybody who opts in. In this reply, ask people to respond with their email address. When they do, the service can automatically subscribe the email address to your station's email list. This makes it easy for your station to build its email list through text messaging opt-ins at events like concerts or on-site promotions. You can promote your text message keyword in lots of places. On your airwaves, on station banners, on wristbands, on the side of the station van, and more. Once people have opted into your email list by text message, don't text them again, and you should be able to avoid the trolls. But be sure to run that by your lawyers first. If you're smart about it, text messaging can be a powerful tool for your station.